What is going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to break down for you something with the Notion API guide where I can actually help you take a Gmail email and turn it into a Notion task.
So I've just received an email, or I have a while ago, that tells me that there's been a coverage issue with my Google Search Console. Now, how do I take this and put it into my tasks in Notion? The Notion API currently does not allow you with Zapier Automate.io to label a Gmail email and then turn that into a Google task or page. So I have a workaround for you. Here is how I do it. I go right click, add tasks, open it up real quick, and then copy and paste in the details what exactly I'm talking about. And then that is the task, and it will go into Notion just like that. I'm taking an email and putting it right into Notion with a nice little workaround. Now, if you go right here into my Notion, you can see that a new coverage issue and the email contents have been placed right into my Notion. But the question is, how do we get here? Let's dive right into that. So I'm gonna make a little table and show you exactly how. So Notion API example, the way that the API works is that you essentially connect something like Automate.io or Zapier.com to Notion. So you can see I already have this made, but I wanna show you guys how to get here. So in my previous Notion API guide, I showed you how to do this. So what you wanna do is you wanna go to apps, search for the app, Notion. I'm gonna show you how to reconnect here. Basically, you go to Notion, authorize, automate.io wants to view and edit pages, add new pages to Dimitri Panici's Notion, and then you can decide what pages you wanna allow access to. So for me, I'm gonna do this one, example API. It's already added, so we allow access, then we're good to go. Now what you then do is you then go into Notion, and you press share, right? Now, this is also a way to do it. Once you have already connected the two, you can connect Zapier or Automate.io. So I'll just click Zapier to show. This is a way that you can also get that connected in there. It's very simple and easy. It's not like the most difficult thing in the world. So I kind of breezed through that. If you have another query about how to do that, ask me in the comment section down below, or go check out my previous Notion API video. So let's set up this actual automation though. All right, so if we go to this Google Tasks Notion, what I'm actually gonna do really quick is I'm gonna put a due date on this one, or just a date, right, in general. Date, and delete this. So I have a date property and I have the description that I need, so that's all I really need to get this set up. So I'm gonna create a bot, goes from Google Tasks to Notion. Select the trigger, new, or updated task, task list, my tasks. Make sure you connect that to Google. It's just whatever Google you're gonna use this Google task for. And then you go to add new database item. Now what database do I wanna decide to pick? So for this purpose, I'm gonna show you the Notion API example. So we have the Notion API example right here. So then what you wanna do is you wanna take this paragraph and you wanna add the task notes. And that'll basically take whatever details you put into the task in there. Then you want to go down here and you want to add the name, so Google task title. And then since we have a date here, we're going to want to put for start date, the task due at, and then this should work. So if we hit save here, let's turn this bot on. So then in order to test things out, I'm gonna once again do this. I'm gonna delete this real quick. I'm gonna go here, we can right click, add to tasks. There's multiple different ways to add it to tasks, but I'm gonna just do this. So right click, add tasks, or we can do this, which is pretty nice as well. And then we can take this and copy it and paste that in there, and then we have this. Now if we go back here, say we're done with it, it's gonna check for a new or updated task in Google. All right, so let's go back to the Notion API example. You can see it had the one where I accidentally didn't put the details in, it had the one where I put the details in, and it's all set up like that. Now there is no date here, but if I had set a date, it would have populated into there as well. So that is how you can connect the Notion API with Gmail, even though you're not allowed to, because if you try doing something similar, if I really quickly show you the other way, oops, Google does not allow transferring to Notion. Why is that? Security. It's a security thing. However, you can just do a really quick workaround. So that's fine.
With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.